Shashi Kala on Wednesday announced she's retiring from active politics. In a statement, she said she will stay away from politics but would pray for the golden rule of Amma. Shashi Kala was referred to as Chinnamma, while Jayalalitha was Amma. But who exactly is Shashi Kala, who shadowed Jayalalitha for over 3 decades, and how she came in contact with this powerful politician? For V.K. Shashi Kala, an ambitious woman, a movie buff who ran a video rental store, her life story is nothing short of a film script. Shashi Kala met Jayalalitha for shooting a propaganda video of hers in the 1980s. Their meeting became frequent and a friendship grew. Jayalalitha was then the propaganda secretary of AIADMK. During that time, AIADMK's founder and 10-time Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, M.G. Ramachandran, fell sick and passed away on 24 December 1987. M.G.'s wife was then elected the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. Jayalalitha was being humiliated by the public and party workers. That's when Shashi Kala entered the scene, summoned her relatives and a gang of 40 people from Mannargudi to make sure that Jayalalitha was safe. By now, Amma was always seen surrounded by Shashi Kala's men, and soon Jayalalitha won the hearts of party men and common people through her campaigns. Jayalalitha threw Janaki out of the post in just 24 days later with a no-confidence vote. Jayalalitha fought many battles, claimed her legacy and became AIADMK's sole leader by 1989. She and her party won the 1991 elections and for the first time, she became the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. Jayalalitha now heavily started depending on Shashi Kala and her gang, and they even moved into her residence to manage all the work from driver to cook to manager. Jayalalitha's supporters alerted her often of the misappropriation of her assets by Shashi Kala and her gang, but she did not give an ear. The public criticism grew and she lost the 1996 elections. However, AIADMK came back to power as she supported Atal Bihari Vajpayee-led NDA government. But here too, Shashi Kala started wielding power. Shashi Kala arranged a tea party for the Congress leader Sonia Gandhi in Delhi in the year 1999. The meet was attended by Jayalalitha, after which she withdrew her support to the NDA government. And Vajpayee-led government lost the no-confidence motion by one vote. Jayalalitha had started believing in Shashi Kala blindly, but the Mannargudi gang was planning to send Jayalalitha to the jail in the disproportionate assets case in 2011 to elect Shashi Kala as Tamil Nadu's next chief minister. Soon, Jayalalitha received news that Shashi Kala was trying to poison her. For the first time, Jayalalitha went for a medical test without consulting Shashi Kala and the gang. She found that she was being fed with sedatives and chemical substances of arsenic. Jayalalitha expelled Shashi Kala and the gang was put behind bars. But surprisingly, after apologizing, Shashi Kala was back and they were friends again. Shashi Kala had distanced herself from all her family members by then, and until Jayalalitha's death in December 2016, Shashi Kala stayed by her side. But for Shashi Kala, the woman behind the phenomenal success of Amma, the one who played decisive role in the party and was the mastermind behind the show, we written off so easily.